Elo ni Jesu mi gba. Elo ni mo san fo ba owo fo rire lori mi. Elo ni mo san, elo ni Jesu mi wa, elo ni mo san, elo ni Jesu mi wa, elo ni mo san, elo ni mo san, elo ni mo san, elo ni mo san.
agbegbe se rede
o ti de bo se nle loluwa mo si
agbegbe se rede
o ti de bo se nle loluwa mo si
Sere o
o se o Olorun mo si
Alade sere
o o se o Olorun mo si
da Isola lulu re
o do o se o do ninu e mi o ninu Olorun mo si
Isola lulu re
o do o se
Thank you.
fellowship of Holy Ghost. Be with me now and forevermore. With the grace of God, sweet fellowship of Holy Ghost. Be with me now and forevermore. Grace of God, sweet fellowship of Holy Ghost. Be with me. Fellowship of Holy Ghost, be with me now and forevermore.
Ijo Oba Ogo, Elo ni Jesu mi ba o.
elu ni mo so o ba ogo o ri re lori mi ro jare elu ni mo so elu ni mo so elu ni mo so o ba ogo elu ni mo so o ba ogo o ri re lori mi
Let's go. Only set of people that are allowed to continue to make noise or that are allowed to continue to talk in this hall are the people that were around when this set was graduating. If you were not born when this set was graduating, I will implore you not to make noise because we will throw you out of this hall. Sorry, okay, I've threatened some people. If I ask them to excuse us in this hall now, this hall will become very small. We appreciate the chairman of today's occasion. He has just stepped in. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we thank you very much for your patience. We need to recognize that because we said we were going to start this meeting for 10 o'clock. I personally look forward to that day when it will be 10 for 10. I look forward to that day. I know it is possible. I know, at least if dollar can be almost 1,000 to a dollar, almost 1,000 to a naira, every other thing too can be possible. It's not the other way around that should be possible. The better way too can be possible. I will have a naira and they will need $10,000 to buy from me. I look forward to that. Well, thank you. We just want to start. The reason why we were waiting, two reasons. We were waiting for the arrival of the chairman of today's occasion, and at the same time, we're also waiting for the chief host of today. The host is already in the house, but we know that Department of Physiotherapy does not exist as just a department. It's a department within the College of Medicine. And so we're waiting for the arrival of the provost of the College of Medicine. I have been duly informed that she's on her way, and I gather that the deputy provost is probably also coming in soon. Don't worry, it's part of the things that you should be praying for, that they will not ever take light. I remember a very young child who was told by his parents that when we get to heaven, there will always be light in heaven. And he believed them. After all, they don't take light according to the parents. So the young boy with his parents went to the United States of America And after 2 weeks of not experiencing power cut, the boy started crying that we have died. They didn't tell me that we have died. He said, ah, you are alive. You are here. Eva, he said, we have died. For 2 weeks, there have been light. That means we have gone to heaven. And you did not tell me. I pray that one day we will not have to tell our children that. Again, I have said almost five prayers today, and we have not started the program. So let's just quickly, I hope the backup is coming so that we can have a conducive environment. We'll just wait some 2 minutes. I'm sure that because the provost needs to walk, you know, elegantly, it will take some time to come down from the stairs. So let's look forward to that. I want to crave your indulgence to just let's get further information from the provost, and then we can commence the program in earnest. Meanwhile, some of us are from the abroad, so I think I'm feeling hot now. So the 92 family members are here, and we are gathered because they asked us to come. For those of us that are not 30 years after graduation, you have challenged us. For those who were 30 years and did not remember to do this, they will look forward to 40, and they will look forward to 50. For you, 40 together, 50 together. Amen. 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 Yes, don't worry. It's still possible. 50, just 20 years time. You guys, by the time you are coming, we need to some place to, at least you still be able to climb the stairs. Maybe when I say 70 years post-graduation, we need to start some of you. Baba Shitu is looking and say, don't ask me to join them here. But you'll be here. You will see. You'll be surprised. You know that Mr. Shitu retired this year at 60. Somebody is not clapping for someone who retired. He's a member of the class. When they told me, I said, Mr. Shitu, class only . That means Baba, serve in the end. Abi, you know the meaning now, serve in the end. There are some people that ask will not allow them to serve. As in, they were open at 28, I'm not about Wakaki, Omo Eloma Wo. As well, Asukosa. Just 2-3 years, so Tito, I can't hide him, my friend. You were thinking of graduating at 27. As we just say, 30. Okay. And if God will at least help you, they will not sit on the resort for 1 year like the last set. The last set, they graduated in February 2020. They finished all exams February 2020. Induction February 2021. 1 year. God, may we not see that again. The owner of your prayer, I'm not saying amen. Yeah. Amen. I think we should reach out to the electrician. Please, let's have the generator on. So, I think it's proper to ask Dr. Tinubu. Okay. I think we should start. We'll await the... Welcome, sir. Hello, sir. We await the arrival of the provost. She will join us along the way. Thank you, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Before we commence anything, shall we rise for the anthems of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and that of the College and the University of Ibadan. BCC, are we good to go?
Oh, Don't worry. As you are sitting down, we are already taking it. We are taking it. Already, we are taking it. We are taking it. Okay, we are finished. Thank you. We appreciate you. If you look at the anthem of the University of Ibadan and that of the College of Medicine, you could see the solemnization of those anthems. It's not like some anthems that when they are singing it, you would think it is... which of them? No, I didn't mention school. I said it would look as if, when they are singing the anthem, it would look as if somebody from all those your musicians, which one of them, this one, Naramali, you would think it's Naramali that they have called to do music. I'll bring to the high table so that I will not be the only one sharing this podium. At least this is the only privilege I have. The only people that are on the left and the right are not even sharing the podium with me. So, photographer, please quickly take me, because it will be the last time that I will be alone on this platform. Please. Okay, yes, what a privilege. You are not... The next time now, people will be sitting here now. So this is, okay, yes. After this, people will be here. Let me invite to the high table the host for today in the person of the current head of department of the Department of Physiotherapy, the first Department of Physiotherapy in the University of Ibadan, of course, but more importantly, in Nigeria. Let me invite Dr. Adesola Christiana Odole to the high table. If it is when the last, she's preparing for some other things, but I will not let you know. But if it were when I was doing back big age, mommy, oh, no, I didn't ask. We are inside a very holy place. I mean, something very serious. I will have asked the host for today is the current head of department. Before I bring to the high table the chairman of today's occasion, let me also bring to the high table the head of department when this set was graduating in 1992. Professor Aderonke Ho Akinpelu. So it looks as if I've called mommy and I've called mama. Does it not look like that? Okay, thank you very much. I think whatever you are going to do today, 92 said, you must reward these cheerleading people. Okay. Yeah, so thank you very much. Let's invite to the high table now the chairman of today's occasion. I'm going to do a form of citation when it gets to the high table, but permit me to welcome the Jagun Balogun of Ibadanland, Oloye Remi Babalola. He is the chairman of today's occasion. Oloye Remi Babalola. Our chairman of today's occasion is a banking and finance professional with over 30 years experience in risk asset management, liability generation, capital market operation, and business development. He has served as the CEO of various investment companies including Wema Securities and Finance PLC, Wema Asset Management Limited, Independent Securities Limited, and Portfolio Advisors Limited. Wait for this, a total asset base of over 10 billion naira, and currently the chairman of Portfolio Advisors Limited, a member of the Nigerian Stock Exchange. I will continue, but I want to say quickly that he's a fellow of the Chartered Institute of Stock Brokers. That is just a bit of what our chairman of today stands for. Chief Oloye, let's be withdrawing the chief. Chief is not qualifying Oloye as much as Oloye. Oloye, you're welcome, sir. Thank you very much. Let me quickly fill the eye table with this set of people. I will bring to the eye table, when she comes around, that's the provost of the College of Medicine. But today we have a guest lecture, and it will be delivered by someone who was also a lecturer then and still a lecturer in this same department of physiotherapy. Will you call him Reverend? Please welcome with me Dr. Adeolu Jaiyesimi, today's lecturer. Say, Reverend Dr. Adeoluwa Olugbenga Jaiyesimi, he will be the guest lecturer for today. Thank you very much. I want to sustain the energy in welcoming with me the president, ICOMA Worldwide. ICOMA means Ibadan College of Medicine Alumni Association, Professor E.O. Otolorin. Professor E.O. Otolorin, thank you very much, sir. We appreciate you for this honor. Worldwide. Thank you, Prof. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. We appreciate you. Thank you for honoring us with your presence, and it came pretty early. Let me invite also to this eye table the president of that set, the set that we are celebrating. He was the president of the Association of Physiotherapy Students, that set, Dr. Oluche Adebari PT, Shagun Adebari PT. Now, remember something. You cannot graduate from the University of Ibadan if you are not a clinical student. If you get into the University of Ibadan and from UI, they say you should go home. You are not a physiotherapy graduate too. You must cross over to UCH, and we celebrate the crossing over like anything. Abisa, crossing over was a big deal, and it's still a big deal now. Yeah, so it's go easy, photocopy. Go easy. Here, on this side of the divide, we have the clinical instructors, we have the clinicians who are part and parcel of the great training that we receive from University of Ibadan. From the University College Hospital, please welcome with me the head of the department and the director of physiotherapy services, Dr. Adetutu Akintayo, as she comes to the high table. For the current student, if your hours are not complete, okay. Thank you very much, ma'am. She will be joined on the eye table by Dr. Oladapo Otaiwo, who was a former head of the department, and she was a part of the clinical instructors and clinicians when this set was also around. One person that will have joined them on the eye table today is no longer with us. He's a great person, and we would have loved to have him on this eye table. Also, a member of this class who would have loved to be here today is also not here. I'm talking about Dr. R.K. Olariwaju P.T., who was also a former head of the department of this department, of the UCH Department of Physiotherapy in the University College Hospital, and Dr. Abiodun Razak P.T., who was a member of this class 92 set, who is also no longer with us on this divide. Shall we please rise for just a minute of silence for these two departed souls? May their two souls continue to rest in peace. Please be seated. Thank you for that honor. I will leave the protocols and the invitation to the high table for now. I will be back to quickly do more. But before I step down from this podium, I want to say thank you to the class of 92 for bringing this to bear. It's a privilege even to be here. Thank you, the ICOMA Secretary General is here, Dr. Gbolahan Obajimi. We appreciate you. Thank you for representing the great pride. Thank you very much. One thing you should know is that if you finish from the College of Medicine, you are assured of a high place already. Merely saying you are from Ibadan. They don't search for the name. You know, there are some names that when you mention, they have to search for it and be sure where is it. The moment you say, I'm from Ibadan, they say, Nigeria? Straight. Let's appreciate our professor, O. Ayoni, for being here. Thank you very much, sir. We appreciate you. We recognize the presence of Dr. Williams, Dr. Shotiloye. We thank you very much for coming here to represent the great citadel. Dr. Omoyemi Ogumike, you are highly recognized, ma'am. Dr. Adewoju, you are highly recognized. We recognize the vice chairman of the ONSP. But before that, let me recognize the vice president of NSP, Nigeria Society of Physiotherapy, ably representing the president here. Thank you, Dr. Felix Odusoya P.T. and Dr. Olusegun Adejari. Thank you, the vice chairman of ONSP. Please kindly bring to my notice anyone who is in the house that needs to be recognized, who will still do the recognition. Let me invite the head of department, Dr. Adesola C. Odole, as she gives a welcome address. Dr. Odole, please.
Thank you, Dr. Dada. Thank you for the introductions. Mr. Chairman, sir, please kindly just permit me to just lay down an existing protocol for today's activity. The Provost, College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, Professor Olayinka, Omigbodun, who I believe will join us in the course of this event, the first female provost of the College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, a professor of psychiatry. I also want to recognize our own, the deputy provost, Professor A.F. Adeniyi, who will also be joining us at this event. The chairman of the occasion, Jagun, Balogun of Ibadanland, Oloye, Remi, Babalola. I recognize you, sir. The president of ICOMA, not just ICOMA Nigeria, not ICOMA or your state, we are talking about ICOMA worldwide. Our own dear Professor E.O. Otolorin. And of course, it won't be fair for me to acknowledge Professor Otolorin and not talk about the Secretary General too. Dr. G. Obajimi, thank you for coming. I recognize the president of Mama, I call her Mama, The HOD of the physiotherapy class of 92, can just imagine, several years ago, Professor Aderonke O. Akipelu. Thank you. The guest lecturer of today's event, Doctor, in the College of Medicine, where you want to address males, you address them with their initials alone. For instance, for Dr. Jaiyesimi, I'll just say Dr. A. O. Jaiyesimi. While for females, you call out the first name and the, followed by the initial. But today, I'm going to call out the full names of of Dr. Jaiyesimi. Dr. Adeolu Oluwagbenga Jaiyesimi. My classmate, who now is the head and the director of physiotherapy services in the UCH, Mrs. M.A. Akitayo, I recognize you. The distinguished class of 1992 set, and of course their president, Dr. Adibari, we've been communicating. I recognize you dearly. Distinguished directors of physiotherapy, I can see all of you, so many of you in the Oyo State Service and in the UCH. I recognize you and I appreciate you. Esteemed elders and professors in the house, Professor Yoni, I recognize you. My own immediate past HOD, Dr. Omoyemi Olubumi Ogumike, I recognize him. Just as I was trying to establish the protocol, somebody just walked in, and I'm going to recognize him before Dr. Dada does. Dr. Dada, you are supposed to recognize him, but I will recognize him before you do that. And that is Professor Boa. Professor B.O.A. Adegoke. Members of the college, BCC. Members of the college, ITU. Esteemed colleagues, elders in the profession, all of you, heads of department here present. And of course, my dear students, I will not leave you out. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to welcome everyone to this epoch-making event. The first time a class of physiotherapy alumni set will be having a reunion during the ICOMA week. Please, let's clap for them. This is the first time. Specifically, their 30th anniversary. This is a sign of many good things to come. I'm not surprised of the event of today. Having interacted with some members of this class of 1992, I remember vividly, even though it's a class of 27 members, 23 males, 4 females. And I remember vividly my interaction with TJ. I don't know if TJ is online. TJ Isolagbenla. My interactions with Mr. Fowowe, my interactions with Dr. Adebari, my interactions with Mr. Shitsu, and last but not the least, my interactions with Mr. Razak, who I co-supervised his MSc dissertation. May his soul rest in peace. The cohesion among them is actually palpable. Well, even though we are celebrating this epoch-making event, that is the first time we'll be having a reunion, this is not to say that we have not benefited from different alumni sets. I can say that with so much certainty that the Department of Physiotherapy, College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, has benefited from the kind gesture and support of different alumni sets. It will be an understatement for me to say that we have not benefited, because we have thrived. As a department, we have thrived a lot with the support of these different alumni sets. Just recently, the class of 1991 donated some items, some very important items to the department. And a member even donated 100 e-books to the department. This particular 1992 set that we are celebrating today, they donated to the department an inverter, everything full with the batteries, the solar, and everything for the old department. That was last year. But of course, we know we are still asking for more. And I'm so sure I got it from the grapevine. You students, just relax. I say relax. There are so many things that they're going to do for us. And I'm so proud of them. Well, this is the first time, like I said, that a reunion a class will be celebrating a reunion. That is the class of 1992. You have already set a pace. And I'm sure other alumni sets will follow suit. I am also sure that our guest lecturer, a teacher of teachers, one of those that taught this particular 1992 set, you will definitely take us to a journey that will make out of us deliverers, restorers, and builders. On this note, I welcome everyone here physically and those joining all over the world virtually to this symposium in commemoration of the reunion of the 1992 class. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, my HOD, always bailing his boys out. Thank you for recognizing Professor BOA Adigoke. One thing that you can never forget is the red barrow that comes whenever you give him something to read. The red barrow, I call the red barrow, go for you, shut up, submit the law. Egg by me now. Thank you very much, sir. It's been very resourceful. 30 years. Thank you. 30 years. What is 30 years called in all these annals of ting ting ting? The first person to know it, we'll talk about, at least you know that 25 years is silver, 50 years is golden, 30 is what? Check now. Google. Okay, so while we are waiting for that, recognize those online, recognize the students in the house. Thank you for remaining steadfast, and we look forward to many more years together. Now, let me invite the chairman of today's occasion. I was doing some form of citation, and I see that the citation is very long. And it's because if you have achieved, you know it's not easy. Let's invite Oloye Remi Babalola as she gives the chairman's opening remarks. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you very much. I must say it's my honor to be given this privilege to chair this occasion. And having said the protocol, I will just recognize the provost in absentia or when it comes to join us and stand on the exim protocol that have been set by the current HOD. As I said, it's my honor to be here with you today to celebrate and also identify with your strive. When my friend that we grew up together in the same Agbole in Ibadan called me from the United States that he just wanted me to join them at this reunion of 30 years and that you want me to chair the occasion. I said, I'm an ordinary broker making my means in Lagos. How will I know how to go Abere or to Egun when you come to the academic setting? Well, he said, no, it's not, he actually want me to add what we call the royal flavor to what you are doing here. And I bring to you the felicitation of His Royal Majesty, the Olubadan of Ibadan, whom I said I stand in prosy for as a line in the Olubadan. I only pray that may Allah let me also get to become the Olubadan. To chair and accept the honor. I think things when we were speaking, and one of them is that this set, after 30 years, and everybody has gone to his own livelihood and life, you still remember your source, where you earn and learn the profession that now earns you a living, shows how gratitude you are to to God and to the institution that made you. The second one is that when I look at your plans and itinerary, that you also feel that you need to give back and also help the some of the needy student within the department. Shows that you know what you have gone through when you are a student and what God has done for you as you are now. And lastly, that you actually, which was confirmed by the HOD now, that they said, so united together, that you always fellowship with each other, do networking and friendship. And I'm sure such friendship will come with a lot of interrelationship and network benefit. So those three things made me to not only identify with you, but to congratulate you for coming up to this 30th anniversary after leaving school. I must commend your HOD 30 years ago, Professor Akinpelu, and thank God for your life. I was sitting with one of your students then. He said, it's just as if how you are 30 years ago. This is a Lord blessings and favor. And I thank God for your life. I also show that they recognize what you've done in their life. Congratulations, and the Lord always bless you every time. It's always a reminiscence. And at times I cover my face that even those of us that left school 35, 34 years ago, we can't come together like this to celebrate. We are in the humanities, and we know we're always looking for money here and there. And everybody's the jackpot here and there. But I feel very fulfilled that definitely I will go back and see what I can do with my own set of 1988. And that we could also come out and do something like this. And I assure you that for all your plans, I would also identify with you and give my own contribution, which I will tell. But one of the chips of the ice badge is that what do they call it? I would pick one of the students, and by the grace of God, see him through one of the indigenous students. Sponsorship. So I'm first donating to sponsor one of the indigenous students throughout the university. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Okay, the friend is TJ Ishalagbela. You know him? Yes, he's one of the classmates. Thank you very much. We are just bringing out the bird from the pocket. So that's just one step. Thank you very much. We appreciate you. And want to say it again, that you are highly welcome to the College of Medicine, Oloye. Now let's invite I will skip the address by the chief host, that's Professor Olayinka Omigbodun. We'll go to the remarks by the head of department of the class of 92. I think I should be calling them about the class of 92. So that there will be a difference between class. We're sorry, the generator had some fault, but I think it has just been rectified. They've been on it since that time, and we hope that we have a good environment soon. So let's invite the head of department during this set, when the set was graduating in 1992, the Professor Adorunke O. Akinpelu.
Thank you very much. Thank you. The chairman, thank you very much for your generosity. Of course, you cannot do less. If you are Isholagbin's last friend, I know him very well. Chairman, our president, ICOMA Worldwide, please permit me to stand on the existing protocol. I acknowledge the provost in absentia. I have been given 5 minutes to talk. If there is a word to describe the 1992 alumni search of physiotherapy department, I will use the word responsible. They have always shown or demonstrated that they are responsible right from school. I was very young in my career, and I was the acting head of department. They did not give me any headache. They were very good, very responsible. Some of them were more outspoken than the other. She too has always been very quiet. Baba Beji. I remember we were just 5 lecturers in the department. Professor Sayer was away on sabbatical leave. And myself, I was the acting head of the department. Professor Amosun was around then before he left for South Africa. Mr. Jaiyesimi has joined the department at that time. And I think Dr. Jaiyesimi, and Dr. Kamal Sonny was also there. 5 of us. We were running an old curriculum. And in the final year, students registered for only one subject. Ask me the name of the subject. Physiotherapy management of all medical and surgical conditions. Management, it was horrible. But despite this, students did such, many of them are still outside the country doing very well. I want to appreciate Amos Adewuyi, who is here from South Africa. Please stand up for recognition. Thank you very much. The set has always been donating to the department, and the head of department has said it, so I will not repeat that. I thank God for your unity, and I have given Adebari the contact of one of you, he told me this morning that he had problem getting in touch with him, but I happen to have his number. Thank you very much for your generosity. Thank you for keeping the flag of Physiotherapy Department, College of Medicine very high. You have set a pace, and I hope that others set, including my set, BOA, I said including our set, we will follow them. Of course. Although we continue to reduce the number. I think about 4 or 5 of us have passed to the glory beyond. But, 20. 8 girls and 12 boys. I remember. But it's okay. So we thank you on behalf. I thank you because you make me proud that you even remembered that I was the head of department when you graduated. It's so delightful. I didn't remember. And when Mrs. Tinubu said I would give this short remark, I had to start looking for your names and say, oh, Oshalagbenla Adebari, Oladoshu. Thank God for the progress you have made in life. You have all done very well. And I pray that God will continue to uphold you in his grace. He will continue to bless you and your homes. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Well, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, can I just quickly crave your indulgence for 1 minute to introduce to you the responsible. Please rise up, Dr. Ademola Adewuyi Piti, Otumba Lanre Oladosu, Dr. Bola Tinubu Piti, Dr. Segun Adebari, Dr. Adini Ademola Fowowe Piti, Dr. Durodola Ismail, and Dr. Hebi Chitu Piti. When we are doing the album, we'll put the responsible. And the other members of the class that are online, most of them are in diaspora, is Dr. Iyo on your set? Fidelis. Is he on your set? Fidelis Iyo. Oh, Fidelis Iyo. Okay, so several of them online now. We recognize the responsible. Now it's time to listen to the lecture. See, if you want to describe Reverend, I think the best thing you can describe Reverend, for me, I just say, if you want encyclopedia, if you want the explanation to be more than the question, and then, you get me? You follow me? So for now, let me hold on to that. Let me invite Dr. Margaret B. Fatudimu, an alumna of the program, to give the citation of the guest lecturer.
Permit me to stand on existing protocol as I invite the guest lecturer for the day as he stands and we listen to his citation.
A brief citation of Dr. Adeoluwa Olugbenga Jaiyesimi. Dr. Adeoluwa Olugbenga Jaiyesimi was born on 13th August 1962. He attended Wasimi African Church Primary School, Ijebu-Ode, before proceeding to Ijebu-Ode Grammar School and later to the Federal Government College, Odogbolu, for his advanced level studies. He obtained a BSc degree in physiotherapy from the University of Ibadan in July 1984. He obtained an MSc in Medical Physiology and PhD in Cardiorespiratory Physiotherapy from the University of Ibadan. He practiced as a physiotherapist at the University of Ilorin Teaching Hospital and Wesley Guild Hospital, Ilesha. Because of his flair for transferring knowledge, he became a lecturer in the Department of Physiology, University of Ibadan in 1987. In the same year, he moved to the Department of Physiology, Ogun State University, now Olabisi Onabanjo University, Agbo-Iwoyi, Nigeria. He later returned to the Department of Physiotherapy, College of Medicine, University of Ibadan to teach physiotherapy in October 1990. He was appointed Honorary Clinical Consultant Physiotherapist by the University College Hospital Ibadan in August 2005. He had served the profession and the nation in various capacities as Internal Auditor, Nigeria Society of Physiotherapy between 1987 and 1989. Financial Secretary, Nigeria Society of Physiotherapy between 1989 and 1993. Chairman Education Committee, Nigeria Society of Physiotherapy, 1996 to 2000. National President, Nigeria Society of Physiotherapy between 2008 and 2012. Board Member, Medical Rehabilitation Therapist Board of Nigeria between 2009 and 2011. Vice Chairman, Health Sector Reform Coalition of Nigeria between 2011 and 2017. Pioneer Registrar, Postgraduate Physiotherapy College of Nigeria between 2013 and 2017. Board Member, Federal Medical Center, Lokoja between 2013 and 2015.
President, College of Medicine Staff, CICS, between 2016 and 2020. Dr. Adeoluwa Olugbenga Jaiyesimi had also served as visiting lecturer and external examiner to other universities, as well as reviewer to reputable learned academic journals, apart from having several publications to his credit. He had attended and presented numerous papers at several local and international conferences. His major research focus is on occupational respiratory health.
Right. Ladies and gentlemen, let's make welcome the guest lecturer for the day, Reverend Adeoluwa Olugbenga Jaiyesimi, as he delivers a lecture titled Deliverers, Restorers, and Builders. Let's make him welcome. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. The Provost, College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, as we await her joining us, Professor Olayinka Omigbodun, the first ever female provost of the first and the best College of Medicine in Nigeria and in Africa. The Deputy Provost, our own in the Physiotherapy Department, Professor A.F. Adeniyi. The Chairman of today's occasion, Jagun Balogun of Ibadanland. The President, ICOMA Worldwide, Professor Otolori. The Secretary General, he has stepped out. We acknowledge you still, Dr. Obajimi. My head of department in the Physiotherapy Department, College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, the Director of Physiotherapy Services, University College Hospital, Ibadan, my teacher, and the president, the head of department, when this set was graduating. Distinguished guests, while I was speaking, our own provost came in, and honor unto whom it is due. Join me in welcoming our own provost, the first female ever provost of the best College of Medicine in Africa. You're welcome, ma. My deputy provost, you're welcome, sir. Ibadan Physiotherapy Set. The celebrants of today. Distinguished guests, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great delight that I stand.
Sorry, permit me to please quickly interrupt this. The provost wants us to know that there is an interview going on. She just honored this set to come here. She will leave soon, but she'll be back to give the speech towards the end of the program. Thank you, and sorry for the interruption. Thank you. Thank you.
Let's celebrate our provost once again. It shows the love she has for our department. Each time we call on her, she's always there for us. We appreciate you at all times, ma. Yes. So it's my great delight to be in our midst this afternoon. And I must appreciate the Ibadan Physiotherapy Class of 1992 for the honor and privilege accorded me by inviting me to deliver the 30th anniversary reunion lecture. I congratulate most heartily the Department of Physiotherapy, College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, for this hosting of our illustrious alumni. I must also congratulate the college and the ICOMA worldwide for the success of the year 2022 Alumni Week, which is already settled by God's grace. I want to approach this lecture by looking at a sector that is relevant to us in our national life, which is the education sector. In the light of the current challenges and what place the alumni set of any training institution can play in relieving the burden, solving the problems at hand. So talking about education, Awolowo, as quoted by Gbadegesin, defined education as the physical and mental culture mechanism by which the personality of a man is formed to the fullest. It has also been described as a process of human development through which one gains greater understanding and control over oneself and one's environment. It includes our minds, our bodies, and our relationships with the people and the world around us. And it is characterized by continual growth and change, far more open-ended and all-inclusive than education, and both formal and informal learning are included. Education makes a people easy to lead, but difficult to drive. Easy to govern, but impossible to enslave. In Nigeria, long before the arrival of the British government, Nigeria, as it was later called, had two major types of education: Islamic education and the indigenous education. Around the 1840s, Western or formal education was introduced into Nigeria by Christian British missionaries. The first missionary school was established by the Anglican Church missionary in 1842, and as at that time only at primary level. Secondary education was established in 1859, the CMS Grammar School being the first secondary school. The first formal pronouncement in education in Nigeria came through the Education Ordinance, promulgated in 1882. The challenges of the first ordinance led to its replacement by a second one in 1887. The idea set up by Lord Frederick Lugard, the then Governor General of Nigeria, after the amalgamation, formed part of the 1916 ordinance. And by the year 1914, schools had multiplied, having 11 secondary schools, 91 missionary schools, and 59 government elementary schools, inclusive of private schools, already established. The need for advanced learning in various fields of study in order to be at par with the global trends, and the need to establish an institution for advanced studies became of paramount consideration. This ideology pioneered the creation of universities. And so in 1948, the first Nigerian university, University College Ibadan, was established, which is traceable to the Elliott Commission in 1943. And thank God, we remain the first and the best still. The number of universities rose from 1 to 5 as early as 1962. And still talking about education. Education is recognized globally as a means of empowering the people for the attainment of national development plans and targets. Bill Clinton, as quoted by Akinwumi, opined education to be the foundation of any nation's economic, political, sociological, and human resource growth. The new Prime Minister of Great Britain, Rishi Sunak, recently stressed that the power of education to transform people's life is worth sacrificing for, and that such disposition is how to build the future. Nigeria's philosophy of education clearly states that there is a need for functional education to promote a democratic, unified Nigeria. One of the five listed set of beliefs upon which Nigeria's philosophy of education is based is that education is an instrument for national development and social change. The goals of education in Nigeria are stated to include, among others, one, provision of equal access to qualitative educational opportunities for all citizens at all levels of education, within and outside the formal school system. And two, development of appropriate skills, mental, physical, and social abilities and competencies to empower the individual to live in and contribute positively to the society. Very apt among the listed goals for tertiary education in the National Policy on Education is the promotion and encouragement of scholarship, entrepreneurship, and community service, in addition to contributing to national development through high-level manpower training. UNESCO, based on the need for developing nations to use education to bridge the gap between them and developed nations, recommended that developing economies should allocate between 20 and 25% of their national budget to the education sector. The United Nations General Assembly, on 3rd December 2018, adopted a resolution proclaiming 24th January as International Day of Education in celebration of the role of education for peace and development. The year 2022 commemoration was celebrated under the theme, Changing Course, Transforming Education. The event, led by the United Nations Educational, Scientific, and Cultural Organization, showcased the most important transformations that have to be nurtured to realize everyone's fundamental right to education and build a more sustainable, inclusive, and peaceful futures. The University of Ibadan, the foremost citadel of advanced learning in our land, established in 1948, is the first university in Nigeria. And until 1962, when it became a full-fledged independent university, it was a college of the University of London in a special relationship scheme. The university, which took off with academic programs in art, science, and medicine, is now a comprehensive citadel of learning with academic programs in 16 faculties. The vision of this great institution is to be a world-class institution for academic excellence geared towards meeting societal needs. And the mission statement includes to expand the frontiers of knowledge through provision of excellent conditions for learning and research, to produce graduates who are worthy in character and sound judgment, to contribute to the transformation of society through creativity and innovation, to serve as a dynamic custodian of society's salutary values and thus sustain its integrity. And of course, the motto of the university, which is written in Latin, means for knowledge and sound judgment. The university, as part of efforts to fulfill the mandate of promoting Nigeria's development, established a research foundation in response to emerging threats to peace and peaceful coexistence in Africa. The university established the Institute for Peace and Strategic Studies to provide actionable studies and solutions. And of course, the University of Ibadan Postgraduate School is well acknowledged within and outside the country as one of the largest in Africa and the flagship of postgraduate education in Nigeria, as it produces the much required human resources for the entire Nigerian university system, the Nigerian public, and private sectors and beyond. Through its alumni and alumni, the University of Ibadan has over the past 7 decades contributed significantly to the political, industrial, economic, and cultural development in Nigeria, thereby fulfilling the purpose of education. University of Ibadan is one of the top universities in the world, ranked between number 151 to 160 in the QS World University ranking by subject in the year 2022. It is best in medicine and economics in Nigeria. The World Health Organization ranking of tertiary health institution shows that UCH, where UI medical students are trained, is the best in West Africa and third in Africa. Our Ibadan College of Medicine, the faculties of the basic medical sciences, clinical sciences, public health, and dentistry are organized as the College of Medicine. The college upholds the same vision and mission statements as the university. The current administration of the College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, came on board in year 2020. Our provost, the first female ever, is Professor Olayinka, Omigbodun, fellow of the African Academy of Science, and is ably supported by our own Professor A.F. Adeniyi from the Department of Physiotherapy. Our amiable and indefatigable provost came on board with a mission statement, which is to work with passion, compassion, humility, commitment, integrity, unwavering focus, and zeal to ensure that the mission of the University of Ibadan, the College of Medicine, each faculty, institute, department, unit, and each individual personal development plan is pursued in a supportive and conducive environment. She presented an 8-point together agenda for the College of Medicine for the period 2020 to 2024 as she serves as provost. The 8-point together agenda is highlighted on the board. I will be referring to two of them later on. Talking about education in Nigeria still, we have what we can refer to as the glory years. From the advent of Nigeria's tertiary institution with University College Ibadan, now University of Ibadan, in 1948, till the late 80s, is a period that had been referred to as glory days of tertiary institutions. It was said to be a period characterized by unprecedented growth and development of students in mind and intellect. A period of unearthing rough diamonds and hewing them into dazzling gemstones. Gaining admission into a university or tertiary institution then was a project. Hardworking and result-oriented persons of different backgrounds met in varsities to gain and exchange ideas, and more importantly, contribute their quota to the advancement of our country in the spirit of independence and patriotism. From this generation, intellectuals and great minds were produced. The Nigerian degree was immensely respected worldwide, with students ahead of their counterparts in various aspects. There was a time when, with our BSc Physiotherapy from the University of Ibadan, you don't need to go through any further examination to get licensed to practice in the UK. Professors and lecturers were smart students who mostly graduated on top of their classes. Those who went overseas for further education were also smart enough to do well on entrance exams that guaranteed their success in foreign universities. They shattered records with their names engraved on academic walls of excellence at various universities in the United States, United Kingdom, Germany, as well as other foreign universities. Lecturers and professors knew their materials and taught them well. They took pride in impacting knowledge, creating the next generation of medical doctors, lawyers, architects, engineers, accountants, historians, teachers, etc. Between 1960 and 1998, university education in Nigeria was competing directly with that of the United Kingdom. Then, Nigerian university education was among the best in the world, particularly in Africa. This period and the ones before it saw the glory days of higher learning in Nigeria. School libraries were an inestimable pride to the nation, and professors were internationally renowned in their corresponding fields. To see foreign instructors and students was neither out of place nor unusual. Nigerian University then was a place suitable for academic pursuit that attracted foreign students from India, Pakistan, and many other countries. In my own set at this same University of Ibadan, I had a classmate who was from Cameroon. The set before me had somebody from Cameroon. Several sets after me had people coming from other countries. American and British-born Nigerians came home in droves for a shot at good education, laced with culture indoctrination. The quality of education was challenging, and the environment was robust and inclusive. Tertiary institutions were truly a citadel for character development, exposure, and enhancement of ideals. As an international paradigm, feeding, accommodation, and even tuition of most students were taken care of by the government. Higher education then was challenging, fun, rewarding, and for the most part, enriching. Nigerian universities at that point produced professionals and great minds, a Nobel laureate, business tycoons, investors, professionals, and so on. Heads of state, presidents, and other national icons ensured that university students, the trustees of our posterity, were their priority. The future looked bright. But as it was in the past, not so today. The glory years are gone. The standard of education that Nigerian schools were known for is no more. Nigeria is reported to have the largest population of out-of-school children in the world, with approximately 10 million of Nigerian children being out of school. Nigerians account for 1 out of every 5 out-of-school children worldwide. According to a 20th September 2016 Vanguard publication, about 3/4 of primary school's age children never attended school. Less than 2/3 of those who were in school completed primary school in 2012, and less than half continued into GSS1. In many of the primary schools, particularly in rural areas, they do not have buildings. Children sit under trees or in open spaces. In townships where they have classrooms, there's no water, not to talk about toilets. The tertiary institutions are now a far cry from the glory days. The sector has virtually been taken over by touts, ready-made election thugs, immoral individuals, and depraved lecturers looking for a share of the so-called national cake. Most universities are grossly dilapidated and unequipped, a shadow of themselves living on past glory. Accommodation, water, electricity, transport, and other basic amenities are gradually becoming non-existent. The infamous strikes have become more frequent, generating more idle minds. The school has become a center for classroom teaching, where theory and hypothesis reign supreme, while practicals, inter-student interactions, political and social awareness, and all-round personal development have been relegated to the background. Tertiary institutions are fast becoming a rendezvous for persons either forced to school or schooling to fulfill all righteousness. Inadequate funding of university education in Nigeria is the greatest developmental problem. University education in Nigeria remains chronically underfunded. The national enthusiasm for education has not been matched with financial and developmental commitments. One of the root causes of the problem of inadequate funding is as a result of government policy of abolition of tuition fees in Nigerian federal universities in 1977. There has been an unprecedented growth of federal university school students' enrollment or population without a corresponding increase in the budgetary allocation. The problem of inadequate funding has led to a general decay in infrastructural development and maintenance. The pressure and demands on the system and his facilities have become so high to the extent that free tuition in Nigerian federal universities may no longer be sustainable. The budgetary allocations from the government could no longer match the increasing burden placed on universities and the neglect of the university as a potentially important motor of development is damaging. A 10-year budgetary allocation to the Nigerian education sector is presented in the first table, table one. And it reveals that for the 10-year period, the education sector got between 4.83% and 9.94%, an average of 7.24%, which is far below the 15 to 20% recommended by UNESCO. It appears no African nation has actually met UNESCO's recommended 25% budgetary allocation to education, but Ghana and South Africa have done much more than Nigeria. And we can see that in table two. And compare what is happening in our neighbor, Ghana, and South Africa, that are also African nations, compared to what we are doing. With the Nigerian government's continued ownership and control of public universities, and therefore the principal obligation of funding and sustaining these institutions, the government appear to be overburdened. And we can see that illustration of that vehicle that is, that looks like the current situation of Nigeria. The load is beyond what the vehicle can cope with. This obligation has become unsustainable. And such position threatens the future of the Nigerian education system. There is a great need to rescue or deliver the education sector from an imminent collapse. Hence, the need for deliverers who are going to deliver the education system. To move the Nigerian educational system out of the brink of collapse, a fundamental overhaul is required. If Nigeria's tertiary education wants a beacon for Africa will ever rise again, a drastic reform that will reduce the dependence of the university on the unsecured and dwindling resources from government is urgently needed. When we look at the third table, table three, so let's go back to table three. You know, talking about fund allocation to federal universities in the year 2022 budget. We see the total allocation to 44 federal universities, 326 billion for recurrent expenditure, and for personnel, 320. The amazing thing is that to 44 federal universities, 25.5 billion is allocated to 44 universities for capital projects, which means that no single university will hardly have 1 billion. If any university is to currently put up this college building now, I'm not sure 1 billion can finish this building. So which means there is no federal university who can, under the budget of year 2022, put up an administrative block like this. Then where are we going? Lack of funds usually does not even make the budget to be fully implemented. Though 25 point something billion is allocated, at the end of the day, we may not have 15 billion released. The next table shows the top five universities with the highest allocations in year 2022 budget. Looking at the allocation, the University of Ibadan, the first university in Nigeria, and the biggest, even in terms of personnel, is coming number five in financial allocation. Does that stand to reason? let's look at allocation for capital project. The University of Ibadan does not even come amongst the top five under allocation for capital project. The danger is quite obvious to those in government. And there had been numerous declarations of commitment to restore the lost glory of Nigeria in education. But it's been all promises and nothing to show. Therefore, as things stand now, we need deliverers that would deliver the education sector from the hands of those that are committed to seeing that it is wrecked or it comes to ruin. We are saying that where we are presently is even behind where we were over 20 years ago. The glory that is lost needs to be restored. We need restorers that will restore that glory. Even if we restore the glory of 20 years ago, we are the ones that went back 20 years. Others have gone ahead. By the time we restore the glory of 20 years ago, others have gone ahead. So we cannot even stop at deliverance, restoration. We must actually build. So we need builders in order to catch up with those that have gone ahead. A publication in the Punch newspaper of 26 January 2022 posited that Nigeria's education sector is in shambles and needs to be salvaged. The education sector needs to be delivered from the hands of those that have hijacked it, as well as those that are determined to wreck it. The glory of the immediate post-independence era and the economic boom era is gone. The performance of the education sector is today far behind what it was 20 years ago. Nigerian University then was a place suitable for academic pursuit that attracted foreign students. A report in the Vanguard newspaper of August 10, 2020 said Nigeria's universities are not in the reckoning of countries benefiting from the international students market, a market that is valued at about $100 billion annually. Nigeria, which was once a choice of such students in the past, is now completely out of the list. Investigation by that newspaper showed that poor infrastructure and unstable academic calendar are the main reasons for the development, and that rather than drawing international students to the country, Nigeria has become a major exporter of students to foreign institutions. Findings show that Nigeria loses billions of dollars yearly to other nations in school fees. Nigerian students are found mainly in universities in the United Kingdom, the United States of America, South Africa, Ghana, Ukraine, Australia, Russia, and among others. According to the Institute of International Education in the US, Nigerian students spend about $514 million, which is about 2.5 trillion naira, on school fees in that country in year 2021 alone. How much does the education sector need in Nigeria? About 19,000 Nigerian students in neighboring Ghana spent about 250 billion naira on school fees the same year 2021. There is urgent need to restore the lost glory of the Nigerian education sector. Restoration talks about regaining the position of about 20 years ago. Between that time and now, while we in Nigeria retrogressed, other nations have moved forward. We therefore, in addition to restoration, need to build and build fast to catch up with those that have gone ahead. To deliver or rescue, restore, and build. The Nigerian educator needs deliverers, restorers, and builders. According to the then president of Academic Staff Union of Polytechnics, Mr. Usman Yusuf Duse, as published in the Whistler of 10th May 2018, government at all levels have continued to pay lip service to restoring the lost glory of Nigeria in education. Standards are obsolete. Regulation and supervision are poor, and working conditions across campuses continue to deteriorate. It appears that we need to follow the example of Apostle Paul In the book of Romans chapter 7 and verse 18 to 24, the struggle of Apostle Paul was narrated, and it culminated in his exclamation, "Who shall deliver me from this body of death?" The good he wanted to do, he could not do. The evil he didn't want to do, he kept doing. So the good Nigerian government should do, they cannot do. So who will deliver the education sector in Nigeria? With the government at all levels in Nigeria paying lip service to the task at hand, we cannot continue to look up to them. We need to ask the question, who shall deliver the Nigerian education sector? Who shall restore the lost glory of the Nigerian education sector? Who shall build up the Nigerian education sector? The corollary is to ask the question this way. Who are the deliverers of the Nigerian education sector? Who are the restorers? Who are the builders? Then we'll find an answer in the prophecy of Prophet Isaiah. In chapter 58 and verse 12, he says, "Out of thee shall come." Out of thee shall come. The NIV rendition says, "Your people shall," and they will be called restorers of the broken walls and builders of ways, paths to walk in. It says, "And they that shall be of thee shall build the old waste places. Thou shalt raise up the foundations of many generations, and thou shalt be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of paths to dwell in." This seems to be a call to the people to repair the walls and restore the city. Actually, it is a promise to the people of what they can achieve if they would do the Lord's will. But I want our attention to be on the identity of the people being referred to here. They that shall be of thee. This implies offsprings or products. And the NIV uses your people. So who are the offsprings, products, or people of the College of Mercy, University of Ibadan? The alumni. The alumni are the deliverers. The alumni are the restorers. The alumni are the builders. Let us therefore look at the example of Father Abraham. In Genesis chapter 14 and verse 14, he said, when Abraham was told that his nephew Lot had been carried captive, he armed his trained servants born in his own house and pursued them unto Dan. They were born in his own house. They were the people fit for the assignment. It is the alumni that were raised in the College of Mercy, University of Ibadan. They are the ones fitted to rescue this institution from the decadence that the haters of education in Nigeria want to impose on us. And they must arise. Our alumni are trained healthcare professionals produced by the College of Mercy, University of Ibadan, the first and the best. Looking at the suggestion of Vincent Essien, according to UNICEF, the education system can be transformed by adequate funding. In a paper titled, excuse me, "Reforming Nigeria's Public University System," a financial expert and public commentator, Mr. Vincent Essien, analyzed various ways the issue of funding and making university education affordable can be achieved. He suggested that the corporate structure of the universities be modified and that the funding aspect be approached from another angle. A major stakeholder identified by him was the alumni. According to him, the alumni of the university should automatically earn a place in the university board of trustees with a commitment to support the university with a minimum funding and management support every year to sustain the legacy and growth of their mother institution. The involvement of alumni in supporting and providing contributions voluntarily to their university is important for maintaining and expanding a university's development by establishing channels that can facilitate closer ties between the alumni, students, and university. It can provide crucial benefits in enriching the students' experience. Thank you very much. It can provide crucial benefits in enriching the students' experience while being at the university. Every alumnus has experienced being a student to becoming a unique and different graduate. Hence, there is potential for all alumni to contribute to the university in different ways and scale. Alumni should see themselves as important stakeholders in the drive to achieve high moral and academic transformation of their alma maters. As higher education becomes more dependent on sources of external funding, alumni provide a large pool of potential donors. In order for colleges and universities to capitalize on their relationship with former students and generate private gifts, they must understand who gives. Using predictive models, institutions of higher education can develop profiles of alumni donors so that they might target efforts to those alumni that are most likely to give. The likelihood of alumni giving has a positive relationship to certain factors, of which I want to mention a few. The student experience while he was in school, including levels of satisfaction. Involvement and relationship in the school life while he was in school. The age, giving to other organizations, how long ago they attended their alma mater, and their income. Amid declining state funding, building a motivated donor base is critical to the financial health of higher education institutions. As a large source of higher education contributions, alumni are an indispensable source of revenue for institutions. In 2017, alumni giving was reported to account for over a quarter of all the higher education donations. In actual figure, 26.1%, totaling $11.37 billion in the USA. The principle of constructive alignment and the together agenda of our indefatigable first female provost of College of Medicine, University of Ibadan. In learning, there is the principle of constructive alignment that requires that the three composite elements, course objectives or outcomes, learning activities and assessment must be properly aligned if effective learning is to take place. This principle is obviously adhered to in the mission statement of Madam Provost. First of all, the vision and mission statements of the college is exactly those of the university, so well, perfectly aligned. And the mission statement of the provost is this. I go over that mission statement again. To work with passion, compassion, humility, commitment, integrity, unwavering focus, and zeal to ensure that the mission of the University of Ibadan, the College of Medicine, each faculty, institute, department, unit, and each individual personal development plan is pursued in a supportive and conducive environment. Perfect alignment. In her 8-point together agenda for the College of Medicine, the H in that together is quite visionary, and it flows into the E that flows. Looking at that H, it says, harnessing the power of our alumni. Harnessing the power of our alumni. And of course, as the power of the alumni is harnessed, it flows into the E, enlarging College of Medicine, University of Ibadan's financial pocket. When the power of the alumni is harnessed, the financial pocket will be enlarged. Let all our alumni therefore know that our provost, when she was writing her together agenda, already has her eyes on you. You must not fail her. I'm glad to say that this trend had been well demonstrated by the alumni of the Department of Physiotherapy College of Medicine, University of Ibadan. Like it was mentioned by my head of department when she was welcoming us, they have been forthcoming in various ways. And like it was mentioned, this particular 1992 set donated a solar power supply system to the old section of the department. You know, a 5.7 kVA solar inverter with four batteries to go with it, which cost them well over 2 million. It was from that set. And that's not the only thing they have done since. Apart from their set, I have here quite a number of other sets that have made similar donations. Solar power inverter and controller, split unit AC, all in one desktop computer set by the 1991 set, solar by 1994 set, 1997 set gave us two projectors and two projectors screens with Logitech presenter, APC UPS, APC surge arrest extension boxes. 1987 class gave us 42 orthopedic physiotherapy textbooks, all in one desktop computer set, laser jet printer, e-books on USB stick. 1990 set gave us a classic flexible spine model. 1995 set gave us split unit AC, multimedia projector, desktop computer, HP scanjet, and I can go on and on, but I wouldn't want to bore you with such a lengthy list. Apart from our alumni being forthcoming in groups in terms of the graduating sets, they also come even as individuals. We have quite a long list, you know, of personal donations from our alumni. Cash donation to handle things, equipment gift, and so on and so forth. And I want to particularly mention two, which is in another dimension, which is what we want to encourage through this lecture. Apart from cash gift, apart from this, there are diverse ways by which we can support the alma mater. My teacher, the woman of steel herself, most of us know, Professor Aniola Sonya, endowed two prizes. She endowed one prize on her own for the best graduating physiotherapist at the preclinical level. And then also endowed another one in the name of her senior brother for the best graduating MSc student in neurophysiotherapy. That's highly encouraging. Another alumnus of the department, Professor J.A. Balogun, also endowed an annual prize. We need more of such. Let it not just be in cash alone, in various ways. And of course, for those who have done, we are Oliver Twist. We want more. Like the Together agenda of Madam Provost, it is time to harness the power of the alumni. If there is any time when that is needed, it is now. Every effort must be made to ensure that our students, while they are still in school, have experiences that would generate good memories about their alma mater in them. So we must learn not to be nasty to them, because if they leave with negative impressions, it affects their commitment in giving back. Such will make them to be better disposed to giving back to the college. The college should come up with smarter ways of our alumni can benefit their alma mater and communicate the same very clearly to all and sundry. So, realizing that we are the deliverers, restorers, and builders, let the deliverers, restorers, and builders arise. Like it is said in the book of Nehemiah, the God of heaven himself will prosper us. Therefore, we, his servants, will arise and build. Therefore, we, the deliverers, we, the restorers, we, the builders of College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, we will arise and we shall build our college. And the God of heaven, he will prosper us. So, great alumni, great ICOMA worldwide, great College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, greatest UI, let us arise to deliver the system from the hands of the enemies of education, restore the glory of the yesteryears, and build a stronger College of Medicine that will stand the challenges of the modern times, and stand without shame in the committee of colleges of medicine all over the world. As we build, the God of heaven will prosper us. May I therefore, on behalf of the College of Medicine, University of Ibadan, say to our alumni, at home and abroad, we are the deliverers, restorers, and builders. We are the ones who have a legacy to preserve and uphold. Let us not continue to expect help where it had never really come and is not likely to come. We are deliverers. Let every alumnus in this hall at this moment say, we are the deliverers.
We are the deliverers.
We are the restorers.
We are the builders.
And to all of us who have listened patiently to all I had to say, I say thank you for your attention and patience.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. We may please be seated. Well, I do not have the responsibility of being a rapporteur, so I'm not going to go over the lecture, but I'm going to appreciate Reverend Dr. Adeoluwa Oluwagbenga Jaiyesimi standing on our HOD's platform. But because of my weight, I don't like standing on existing protocol, because when I stand, the protocol can collapse. Are you not seeing me? Yes, you appreciate the kind of weight that I carry. So for me, I just want to touch the existing protocol, because even my touch can fall the protocol. Thank you very much, Reverend. Well, I cannot but say thank you for doing justice. When I saw the title, I said, who will bring a reverend to come and do deliverance? I said, I know it's deliverer, they said. And you have done justice to that. We appreciate you, Reverend. We thank you very much. He said something, just one thing that I want to quickly point attention to. He said, every alumnus has experienced being a student, and I say, except some people. Okay. You know, some people, they know that they graduated from UI. But if they ask them, obviously, they can't remember. But these ones can remember the school, and here we are celebrating them. We thank you, the 92 Ibadan class, physiotherapy class of 92, for bringing this together. Thank you for allowing, according to my yoga, the Moses of our time. Because anytime Reverend turns like this, it will look like Moses at the back. I say, Baba John Mose. Then this one now looked like Pa Mose. So when he handed it over to me, I said, everyone say Joshua. I am not Joshua, so I cannot continue from where you start. So for me, I am just doing my own. I'm not Joshua. How can Moses? I said, let me collect it so that it does not look like I say, I'd respect another elder. So we have some awards, a couple of awards to quickly be done with. We thank you, everyone, for your patience, and we can assure you that we'll be out in no time now. The first set of awards will be given to in appreciation of those who contributed to the training of the Ibadan physiotherapy class of 92. I want the Ibadan people, 92 people, to please pay attention to this. To do this award will be our Professor Adironke Akinpelu and the president of APS 91-92 said. When I said president of APS, Dorcas wanted to stand up. Hold on. I'm talking about 91-92. Ah, go easy. 91-92. Yeah, I know what it. 91-92. The SS3 going to SS1. Yeah, even our not to talk of. So, so let's invite Dr. Ewo Adebayori PT and Professor Adeyanke Akinpelu as we, the people that we are presenting, you are presenting, please come, Dr. Adebayori, and he's going to present an award, rather, to Professor Adeyanke Akinpelu. Professor Adeyanke Akinpelu was the head of department when this class of 92 was there. So do that along with our incredible indulgence of the head of department, the current head of department, to please come along with him. The provost would have been here to do this along, but we could. So I would say that the head of department is ably representing the provost, since she's the next in line when it comes to that. So, Dr. Adebayori and the provost in absentia, please present to the head of department of the class.
Okay, just read it. Professor, just read it. Physiotherapy class of 1992, Award of Excellence, presented to Professor Adeyanke O. Akinpelu in recognition of your contribution as head of department to physiotherapy class of 1992 during their clinical training, presented at the 30 years graduation anniversary of the physiotherapy class of 1992. November 8th, 2022. Mr. Chairman, sir, you help us present the award, sir.
It's my honor to present it to you in appreciation of your contribution to the class. Congratulations.
Thank you. You can take the picture. Just, ma'am, quickly take the picture. Oh, yeah. So we prepare the second award will be given to the clinical instructors when they were in school. This alumni said, want to recognize these two people. First, they want to recognize Dr. Oladapo Taiwo, who is not here but will be represented by Dr. Adetutu Akintayo. And they want to recognize Dr. R.K. Olariwaju, who will be represented by Oladoyin Ramat Olariwaju and Lukman Olariwaju. The two of you should please come. Those are the children of Baba. Please come. Come, Lukman. Lukman, join. So let's do them. Dr. Taiwo, on behalf of Dr. Taiwo, let me invite to join the president, Dr. Adeniyi Fowe. Dr. Adeniyi Fowe, please join the president as we do this. He's also 92 set. He's Fowe, so take note of that.
Yeah. This award is presented to Dr. Oladapo Olufumilola Taiwo in recognition of your support and contribution towards the clinical training of physiotherapy students like us, well, then at the University College Hospital, Ibadan. Thank you very much.
No, please, let's do Dr. Olariwaju. On behalf of Dr. Olariwaju, these are the children of Dr. Olariwaju. Oladoyin is a physiotherapist too. 90-something set? Oh yeah.
So this is presented to Mr. Rasak Kajola. Kajobola Olanrewaju, in recognition of your support and contributions towards the clinical training of physiotherapy students at University College Hospital Ibadan, presented on the 8th November 2022.
Thank you, Mr. Dr. Fowler. No, President, you can't go. You and Chairman are permanent residents here. Let's invite Dr. Larry Oladosu, PT, to do the next presentation. President, you cannot go. You are permanent. Permanent secretary, no? Join. He is going to join you. Three classmates of this 92 set are going to be awarded. First, Dr. Bola Shitupiti. He's surprised. He said, in recognition of meritorious service to the Oyo State Hospital Management Board.
The Ibadan Physiotherapy Class of 92, Award of Excellence presented to A. Bola Shitu in recognition of your excellent performance as a physiotherapist for 28 years in the civil service of your state and as the first director of physiotherapy service of your state's hospital management board. We presented at this 30th birthday anniversary, Physiotherapy Class of 92. We would like to call Aikoma President to present to you. Aikoma. So Aikoma, present the award to Ibola Shitu. He's the first to retire in our set. We call him Pashitu.
So thank you, Pashitu, for your... Okay, so let me crave the indulgence of the chairman to just finish this. Dr. Funsho Arumiyo. It's Aruniyo. Thank you very much. He's also a member of the class and is going to have this presentation. It's not around, so the president of the class can take it on his behalf. Okay. Let me invite the SA man. Bladder. You are coming.
Yeah. The award of appreciation presented to Dr. Funsho Aruniyo Owohunwa, in appreciation of your relentless efforts as chairman of the planning committee and financial contribution towards the success of this program, We the 92 sets appreciate you. You really encourage some of our sets when we started this program, even though, during the solar presentation. You contribute immensely, and we appreciate you so that you can do more.
Thank you very much, President. Thank you very much, sir. Yes, we're done. Thank you. Let's quickly do cutting of cake, because you know why I want to cut the cake, so that everybody will eat. We are not doing a cake that you will just be... There is no point bringing cake, and then they will not return it. I want to eat part of the cake. So let's cut it. I know they are capable. It's just what they have planned is that everyone should go with a 38 cake, but we say they should reduce it so that we can just take this one alone. So for now, how do we cut the cake? Let's invite first. Please come and help us bring the cake to the middle. Oh yeah, Uncle Elijah, how about we cake? Elijah. Okay, you should be there. This space. Okay, they said we should be there. I was looking at space. But if you say we should be there, who am I? So let's invite the distinguished members of the I-table. Let's just be around the table. Especially the class president or the class rep. Let's go. Okay, they've agreed to carry it. Hope it's not a plastic Lego. Oh yeah, the alumni, please, the alumni. It's our cake. Come. It's our cake. I conduct deliverance service for free. Okay, so the alumni, the Ibadan. Yes. No, everybody can join them, then they will stay behind to take it. The lady will be in the middle, only one lady. In their class, they had four or five ladies. Four ladies and how many? 22 guys. And the PT class one, yeah. Okay, so what do we spell? Restorer or the builder? No, builder is better. Or 92. That is 92. I mean NINNETYTWO 92. Thank you. No, just wait. Let's make sure that the pictures are taken, the pictures are captured. Photographer, please, these are the moments. No, come and give us photograph of us back in the camera. This is the one that you should have. Yes, thank you. Okay, thank you. Hope we have caught. Thank you. Thank you, members of the IT table. We appreciate it. Okay, the class, they say you should take one picture with the cake alone so that we can. Please, sorry for the trouble. So that will be the class picture. Sorry for the trouble. The last award will be presented by the head of department and the chairman. This last award Oh, the Akuma secretary is here. Ah, and I've not given you assignment. I must. Okay, keep back. Aha. Uh-huh. No, you won't. Because Secretary General. Are we good? Okay. President, please help me hold on, sir. And then the head of the department and the chairman, please come with me as we make this presentation to the guest lecturer of the Deliverers, Restorers, and Builders. This class would love to make a presentation of an award to Reverend Dr. A.O. Jaiyesimi. Please let the chairman do it, because the chairman was invited by one of them.
The physiotherapy class of 92, award of honor presented to Dr. A.O. Jaiyesimi in recognition and appreciation of your effort as a guest speaker at the 30th graduation anniversary of the physiotherapy class of 92, dated 8 November 2022. Coalition appreciation.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Secretary. Appreciate you. We'll be coming soon with our own restoration. I will be. Oh, okay. Don't worry, we'll be doing 25 years. We will do 25 years so that it can be faster. So let's quickly take some goodwill messages. I will hold on to item number 10. Let's quickly take goodwill messages from Professor E.O. Tolorin, and then we take it also from Dr. Muibat Akitayo. Professor Tolorin is the president of ICOMA. All of us are part of ICOMA. ICOMA attendee, please.
The chairman, Oloye. The guest speaker, Dr. Jaiyesimi, Provost in Absentia, Deputy Provost in Absentia, and all protocols duly observed, please. Dr. Jaiyesimi has done an excellent work of promoting the alumni. I think we should give it the title of the PRO of Alumni Association. I thank you for inviting me to this event. For many of you, 30 years will be a very short time. Time really flies. And coming back to celebrate during our homecoming week, it's really a delight. I associate myself with all that was said by the guest lecturer. I just want to add one or two things. Yes, it is true this quality of education in our country is falling. We have an excellent analysis, and we talk about it all the time. My advice to you, go and get your PVC. Get your permanent voter's card. Take back your country from those that have no interest in education. Over the years, I've been absolutely frustrated by what is happening in this country. Our priorities, in my opinion, are upside down. You showed us 25 billion naira for capital expenditure for 44 tertiary institutions. Our National Assembly of 405 people has a budget of 151 billion. Just 400 and something people. So you can see that our priorities have just not been in the right order. And we've had numerous tests. We've given plenty of time for this to be corrected. It has not worked. The only solution is for the young people whose future is at stake to get up, take their PVCs, identify someone that they think can make a difference. There's no point just talking about this repeatedly. About 7 years ago, the executive of Sultan Bello Hall invited me. I'm a great Bellite. They invited me to come and talk to them. And I said exactly the same thing. When the young ones are tired, when the young ones see their future being played with, they will go and register, they will take their PVC, and they will go and vote for people who will make a difference in their lives. I think that time has come. Please, let's get this message. I believe these are many students here, right? Yes. ASU strike. Welcome back. I'm sure you're not happy about it. So get your PVC and make sure you vote for a different group of people that can change or assure your future. Secondly, I'd like to thank all the alumni who have been making contributions to try to sustain this institution, this great institution that we're very proud of. The College of Medicine started supporting his students' program to try to support indigent students who are having challenges paying for their school fees. I'm glad that I think I'm seeing now that physiotherapy alumni are also coming forward to support physiotherapy students. Because when this started and alumni were dropping money, it was mostly MBBS, BDS, and I was asking the question, where is physiotherapy? But I think you are now responding to that call, and 30 years is enough to build on your finances so that you can give back to support some of the students. I'm happy you invited somebody who is very versed in stockbroking as your chairman. Sir, very happy to meet you. I hope you can link up with all those stock owners, the Dangotes, you know, the Otedolas. We are offering them the opportunity to have a legacy in the College of Medicine. Our accreditation as a College of Medicine is being threatened because we don't have enough accommodation for all clinical students. And we have been asked to build more hostels. And we are doing that. We have 5 or 6 blocks that we want to build, costing 2.5 billion. We are very grateful that one of our alumni in the US gave us $1 million. Professor Philip Ozua gave us $1 million. But his $1 million does not get us to 2.5 billion naira. Where are our stock owners in this country? Please, if you have connection, link us up with some of the Nigerian rich people. Politics is not the only place to donate money. Let us donate money. We will name the buildings after them. We will have Dangote Hostel. We will have Otedola Hostel. We will put their names there. And their children and grandchildren will forever remember. So please, if you are in a position to link us up with such generous people, we would like to be linked up. I thank all the other alumni classes, MBBS, BDS, who have been donating. And in 2 days' time, we will be honoring some of them, some of those classes, giving some award to them. The class of 1982 suddenly came and said they are doing 40 years of leaving this college. And they decided for each year, they will give 1 million. They give us 40 million naira. Another class met in the US at dinner, the reunion dinner. They started raising money. They raised $30,000. So we are really grateful for the response that we are getting. It's just that the task is so heavy. We are very far from our target of 2.5 billion naira to build the entire complex. So we are asking other classes to do the same, individuals, and those of you who have rich parents, even some of these students, they are very rich parents. I remember a parent came for an induction here, and the provost talked about this. And after the meeting, she followed the provost to the office and pledged 20 million naira in 4 installments. She has redeemed 2 installments. So those of you from rich homes, please tell your parents we are raising money for our hostels. And we don't mind, like I said, we can name the hostel after them. Let them just come and support us. We can no longer rely on government, and it is really unrealistic to rely on government to fully fund 44 tertiary health institutions. It's not realistic. And that's not what is done in other parts of the world. Yale, Harvard, Princeton, all these other universities, they are mostly funded by the alumni, from the research work and alumni. So we are getting to that point where we need to be more effective in supporting this institution so that we can maintain the quality for which we are known for. If the quality keeps going down, all the benefits you get outside of this of the shores of this country, when you mention Ibadan, they will disappear. They start asking, Ibadan what? So we need to maintain the quality. And I hope that all the students, I apologize on behalf of ASU for the challenges you have while passing through the college. But in spite of these challenges, when you finish, you realize that this is still the best college of medicine in Nigeria and in Africa. And you'll be grateful and happy to come back to give back to that institution that made you. I'm a very proud alumnus. I graduated 50 years ago. I left this hall in 1972. And I have no regret whatsoever. That qualification has carried me all over the world. And I've been proudly displaying it. Whatever I achieved, I was just building on that original qualification. So I thank you for inviting me once again. Thank you for the excellent lecture. I must invite you once more to come and be PRO and talk about the role of alumni so that everybody knows what we should be doing. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. So at least two things came out. Reverend, that's a role. That's one. Number two, respect your elders. Respect your elder. 50. Ah. I'm by me at mammy Josh and marrying by any. That was the year they got married. So you can imagine that one. Sir. Ah. Thank you so much, sir. Let's continue in the spirit of the goodwill messages. Let's invite Dr. Akintayo. We need you to, so that it doesn't look as if only one leg, two legs, please.
Thank you, Dr. Dada. The chairman of this occasion, sir, Oloye, Remi, Babalola, the Jagun, Balogun of Ibadanland. I'm really happy that you are the one here today, you know, because I'm related to Ibadan people. So when I see them, I give them respect. Like the MC has said, we should give respect to whom respect is due. And then please permit me, sir, to lean on the existing protocol. I don't have so much time. I feel honored and privileged to be part of this event. As we all know, and as we have heard today, alumni associations are really very unique. We have heard here from our erudite lecturer, my own brother himself. I did not expect anything less from him. Thank you for doing good justice to that topic. That alumni associations are deliverers, they are restorers, and they are builders. So they are very unique. They come together to synergize, you know, to work together to pay back into the system. And that is what this Ibadan Physiotherapy Class of 92 have done. So we are really very proud of you in the clinic. And we are proud of your achievements. I am particularly proud of, you know, the way you have worked together to even help yourselves, the mutual benefit that you have been able to derive from this association. And I think it is worthy, you know, of emulation. So thank you very much, the Ibadan class. I remember when I met them for the first time. I mean, I was a bloody copper when I came into UCH. And I met this class. I got to know quite a few of them. And even today, one of them is one of my very good lieutenants who I depend on. I can travel, I can leave the department in an able hand, and I know there is no problem. So please, I want to recognize Bolanle Modupe Stella Tinubu. And also among them here is somebody that, you know, I can't forget the name. 1989, one of the clinicians gave him a nickname and called him Shekoni. And up till today, I still call him Shekoni any time I meet him. Mr. Fowowe Adeniji, please. And then Mr. Shitu, like has been said, very quiet. You know, I've known him since then, since 1989. Is very quiet, cool. And Mr. Isholagbe Inlai, no, he must be online. TJ, we've been very close. A few weeks ago, I still contacted him. I needed a number of somebody in Nigeria. You can imagine, and I called somebody in the US to say, please give me the contact of this person. And he did, to show you the level of closeness. So this class, we really appreciate you. You know, we are very grateful for what you have done. You've been very good, you know, to your alma mater. And sir, the Ibadan College of Medicine has a very good alumni association that has been very dynamic. And this class has been part of that dynamism. They've been very vibrant in giving back. And like it's been said today here, this is the first of its kind. You have come home, you know, to celebrate 30 years of your graduation, of your leaving school, and it is something good that is worthy of emulation. I want to speak to the students here, like our president, the international president, has spoken. You see, this is the time for a change in Nigeria. When this present government were coming in a few years back, they said they were bringing change, but we have not seen it. It's been a mantra. To see change, any change that you are expecting must start from you. This country has gone to a state of, I don't know, we've really gone down in every sector, education, economy, everything. And we need people that will arise and bring the change that we need. You have been advised today, go and get your PVC so that you can start from there to bring the change. Then also in your little corner where you are, be the change that Nigeria needs. Every one of us must work together. Students, every Nigerian, we must arise. We heard when my brother said it, arise and build. To be able to build, all of us, to build this nation together, we must all arise in our little corners, you know, and join hands together to build. So arise, everyone in this hall. I'm challenging all of us, every single one of us, to arise, to be the deliverer that Nigeria needs, to be the restorer that we have been expecting, and to come together to build this nation. And we know when we join hands together, we would have the Nigeria of our dreams. Once again, I want to congratulate the Ibadan Physiotherapy Class of 92. I want to wish you more grace, greater impact, as you continue the good work. God bless you.
Okay, just the last goodwill message. But before then, if you have this program booklet, I want you to look at the back of the program. You will see the picture of... Please, as part of what we'll be using as a complimentary gift, if you can identify the ones that are in the hall with us, then just, but me, I just want to know the person that is wearing socks. Yeah. This person that is wearing socks. Who? Who? Oh, you know him, and you are still in contact with him. Oh, send my good way to him. Let me invite the representative of the president of the Nigerian Society of Physiotherapy, the vice president, as he gives the good way message to this class.
Thank you, Dr. Dada. Yeah, the chairman of this occasion, Oloye, Remi Babalola, Jagun Balogun of Ibadanland, you are highly recognized. The provost in absentia, I don't even know if to lean or stand or touch the existing protocol, but I know the protocol was well established. However, I will still have to extend courtesies to some recognized people around here. So I must appreciate the head of Department of Physiotherapy, Dr. Adesola Odole. You are welcome, you are recognized. My own teacher, Professor Akinpelu, you are also recognized. My head of department, Dr. Adetutu Akintayo, a very wonderful mother around here, you are highly recognized. And I also recognize you, sir, the President ACOMA Worldwide, Professor E.O. Otolorin. Thank you so much for being here. The guest speaker of the day, he has given us a very strategic lecture as regards the reason why we are here. And I must appreciate you for that. He has made the whole essence of this a very, very explicit for the children or the undergraduate students to understand the purpose and essence of Alumni Association. So thank you, sir, for that wonderful lecture. I must also not fail to recognize the fact that our guest speaker today happens to be a fellow of Nigerian Society of Physiotherapy. That is the highest honor that we have in the profession. So we thank you for that. I also want to quickly express appreciation to our elders that are here present and to the students who are here to also listen and all distinguished physiotherapists. It is a thing of joy for me to be here, and I want to say that I want to associate myself with the set of 92 on this wonderful celebration. 30 years is not a joke in the life of people, especially after graduation. And for them to have come up with something that needs to be recognized, I think, is worthy of an applause. The class of 92 coming up with this at this stage, I must say quite a number of sets will be dreaming of achieving this kind of set goals. It might not be that simple. I know that there are quite a number of sets that have one challenge or the other, and that makes it difficult for them. So for you to have planned this and execute at the same time, seeing that this mission is accomplished today, it's a wonderful one. So I congratulate you very much on that. It's important that we all take note of one thing, which has been very clear today. Funding of education has been very, very challenging, and it's becoming increasingly obvious that the federal government of Nigeria cannot solely fund education again. And that is why alumni associations need to come up and assist in funding or support the available funding of our education. This becomes necessary in order for our universities to still be able to compete with the rest of the world in terms of training and standard of training everywhere in the world. So we appreciate you for coming up with this idea, and I'm sure you have given back to your alma mater. I'm very, very sure a number of sets will be stimulated by this contribution and what you have been able to achieve today. I am here on behalf of my president, who also believes that what you are doing today is quite relevant to the development of the profession. There are quite a number of reforms that are going on, and we believe that various alumni can make what we can call technical contribution or support to our various programs, especially in terms of postgraduate training and the rest of them. So I must commend you for that. And I'm also aware that a number of you have been very, very active, and you have been very, very supportive of the profession. At least I remember Dr. Fuwuwe happens to be the chairman of ONSP at some point. Dr. Ladoshu was chairman standing committee at some point. And Oga Adebari here is very, very vibrant and active in NSP. So I'm so impressed, and I'm happy that I associate with you today. What you have done, you have shown that you are leaders, and that is why you have probably been tagged as responsible people. And that is the world we all need to take with us. We need to be responsible. The profession itself has conferred huge responsibility on us, and that is why you can see it demonstrated by these, our seniors. So we appreciate you for that, and I congratulate you once more. I also want to congratulate the Department of Physiotherapy USH that, based on your previous efforts, your students who had left feel that it was nice and correct for them to give back. It's because of their experience at that department, and that is why they are willing to sacrifice in order to give back to the department. So I also congratulate the department for this achievement. So I thank everybody that is here for coming and for listening to us. Congratulations once again on this anniversary to the set of 92 Physiotherapy Department, University of Ibadan. Thank you.
So, in the spirit of giving back, this set wants to do something more. this set of class of 92 says they want to sponsor a student to ensure that a child or a student is not denied education. Let me invite Dr. A.A. Adewi, DPT, the President, National Association of Physiotherapy Students, 1991-1992. He is President, Association of Physiotherapy Students. But you know, because Ibadan was the only school, the student body said it's Association of Physiotherapy Students, because that was the only school. So our own does not have any name, just association. But people like Ife, they have Ife, Ifupsa. They put Ifupsa, but UIAPS. But E is the National Association of Physiotherapy Students. Dr. Adewoyi, DPT, you're welcome as you take the sponsor a student program. Thank you.
Oloye, Remi, Babalola, chairman of the occasion, I give you due regards. I bring good tidings from all the diaspora all over the world in the 92 set that I represent today. It was a tough decision for me also to come down as a person. And I also have to recognize all protocols. Prof, my mother, I remember you very well, very, very well. Dr. Jaiyesimi, and all protocols observed. I'll be very, very short because of time. Here we are today in this same hall. In 1990, I invited the governor of Oyo State here for a launching of a journal, if Professor Akipelu can remember. Governor Adisa was here when we were launching a journal in 1990. I brought him here. Here we are, 30 years after. All my colleagues are smiling with glasses over their face. And some outside the country. We started as 27 students. We graduated with 4 ladies and 23 gentlemen. We are all diverse. We are all diverse in every part of the world. I'm resident in South Africa. I've been there for 20 years. From there, I've visited every part of the world. I did my DPT also in USA. A lot of my colleagues have also done that, including those ones who are at home. But we remember home, and we have been nursing this program that we want to give back to the school that made us who we are. I can stand tall on the soil of South Africa today that I graduated from College of Medicine, University of Ibadan. This is the university that made all of us who we are and that made us. We have built upon that legacy, and we want to give back to the students, less privileged students. We want to support them. It will be the first initiative by my class, my 92 set, to give back to the less privileged student. This brings me to the chairman of the occasion. Some of us have decided that we are going to take 20 students, my set. We are going to take 20 students and sponsor them. In line with this, one of my colleagues and my roommate, Dr. Ladimeji Stevens, who is based in Baltimore, Maryland, has a foundation called Good Son Foundation, and he has decided to sponsor two students. Please give him a round. Other ones who don't want me to mention their name are also in the program that we want to give to the less privileged, brilliant indigent students coming from this school. We want to give back as alumni from University of Ibadan. We now want to give back. Oloye, Remi, Babalola, we invited you here today to felicitate with us and also to support our 20-student program to help any less privileged Nigerian student from University of Ibadan, College of Medicine. We want to raise their head up so that one day they can also stand here and they say they are giving 40 students back. I want you to join me here, sir. I want you to join me. I want to first of all thank you for joining us in this program. TJ is my very, very close friend. We met in Houston. He invited me to Houston, Texas. I know you are very, very close to him. And since I came down, I've been discussing with the local organizing committee. 20 students will not cost you anything. 20 students will not cost you anything. We want to give back to Ibadan. We want to give back to students. We want us to support us very well. I know you can do 8 million naira is nothing. He is an astute businessman. He's a stockbroker. He can count money in dollars. He can count money in sterlings and tell us that this is what we can give. I'm trying to coerce with him to decide the support he's going to give to my set. And he has given me the inkling in my ear, which I will not announce to the public so that you don't go and chase him around. I want to thank you, Oloye, Babalola, so much for your support. For you, the students, in 400 level, 500 level, this is a pragmatic view we are starting, and we want other set to follow us. 92 set to continue to support Physiotherapy Department, College of Medicine. I give you all thanks.
Thank you, Blada. Help me appreciate my Blada. You don't know anything. The moment he started speaking, I said, did we bring an Ugandan or a South African? Now I know why. 20 years, you have already become a South African Nigerian. So that we don't waste much time, we appreciate you. I'm not going to say this on behalf of anybody. I say it on behalf of the students. I'm the current undergraduate coordinator, and I know what it means to take this kind of burden off the students. We have lots of brilliant ones who can now focus on the business of studying instead of thinking how they will pay school fees. Some of them needed to do some manual jobs, even last semester, or last session rather, in order to pay their school fees. We are very grateful to you all. Thank you, class of 92. Okay, the cake has been cooked, and so we don't need to talk about cutting of cake again. What I'm expecting now in item number 12 is that the cake is being disbursed. I'm not going without eating that cake, oh, because if you are 30 and above, you are the only ones that can eat the cake. Abi? No answer to that one. Let us invite the College of Medicine Ceremonials Committee, the chairperson. Okay, before I bring the chairperson of ceremonial, I have been asked to read a message that has been sent to my phone. And I'm reading the message. Kindly read my congratulatory message to the audience. Hearty congratulations to members of the Ibadan Physiotherapy Class of 1992 on the occasion of their 38th anniversary reunion celebration. To God be all the honor and the glory. You have done our college proud. Stay blessed. Wu sent the message. Emeritus Professor E. Oluwole Akande, OON, Foundation Provost, College of Medicine UI, and the pioneer Chief Medical Director, UCH Ibadan, and past president of ICOMA Worldwide. He had been online since we started. Thank you, Prof. We appreciate you. We're so grateful to you for the message. The intel still reached me is that the interview is still ongoing. I would not want to put our dear provost under unnecessary burden. I'm sure that you met with the provost yesterday. You did a courtesy visit. I'm sure that you could see they had an interview and she chairs the interview. So please apologies for that so that we don't have to disrupt the interview. Let's invite the chairperson, ceremonial committee of the College of Medicine, Dr. Nse Odunaya.
Odusonya is Ijebu. Odunaya is Ijebu. That's why. Thank you very much, Dr. Dada. Today is a very beautiful day, and I'm elated to stand here to do this job of giving votes of thanks. But I'm doing this job in two capacities, you know. I am immediate senior of this class. I graduated 1991. So we have interacted a lot in the past. All the faces are very familiar faces, the faces online and the faces here. I'm so proud to be here. And as a ceremonial chair, I'm doing this again too. Thank you very much. But let me not forget the protocol, the chairman, sir. Thank you very much for being here. I won't extend courtesies because I must observe protocol. Thank you very much, sir, for all you have done today, for the patience. The ICOMA president is our living ancestor. Thank you so much, sir, for all you do. Every time we call on him, he comes to us. Sir, thank you so much. The guest lecturer, he is my teacher and is my mentor in unit of cardiorespiratory. Reverend Jaiyesimi is an orator. And we enjoyed your lecture, sir. Thank you very much for all the dissection. We did not even check time because of what you did. Thank you so much, sir. You already been invited to ICOMA for publicity. My professor, Mama Akinpelu, as we always call you. She was also my HOD when I was graduating, so she's been HOD for many of us. Thank you very much, Ma, for all you do to our department. My head of department, Dr. Adesola C. Odole, the present acting head of the Department of Physiotherapy. Thank you very much, ma'am, for all you do. Since she came, we have had a lot of transformation, a lot of beautiful things happening in the department. And what is happening now is also a sign of many good things to come. My HOD, UCH, thank you so much, sis, for all you do. Thank you very much for all your patience. Adebari, Thank you so much. Initially, we said this is the first reunion we are having in physiotherapy. And so to say, the one coming during ICOMA week. But somebody corrected me while I sat there that 5 years ago, a group came. It's just that it did not happen in the ICOMA week. And we did not have all this that we are having. So for you to set this pace and to do this, we are very grateful for 1992 set. You have laid example, and it's a good one. We will follow. I want to thank all the people online, and I want to thank our living ancestor, Emeritus Professor Oluwole Akonde, for joining us and for sending his message. Secretary General Aikoma, thank you so much. I know you are a very busy person, Dr. Bajimi. Sitting here, I think we should applaud Dr. Bajimi. Thank you so much for coming. For all the students, all my colleagues, oh, I'm sorry, I'm going back to the department. There are very seniors here, elders. Professor Adegu Kisa, Professor Yoni Issa, all my seniors and all my colleagues here from University College Hospital, from Oyo State Hospital Management, and all the people that have come to grace this occasion to make it what it is today. And you're giving us this beautiful park, 1992 set. We are very proud of you. Bola, I did not forget you. You know you're my junior. Thank you very much, everyone, for all you have done. Thank you, one. Thank you all. All I have to do now is to say that the good Lord of Reverend Jaiyesimi, the great preacher, will take us all to our various destination. Thank you so much.
Okay, oh, Ijagba ni wonja, they are fighting the fight of Agba. So if you say senior, there's a senior of senior. But if all of us are still talking about senior, always point your finger to where senior is. Living ancestor. You guys, when you want to address me now, be calling me living ancestor, at least in your class, when I get to your class. But when we are here, thank you very much, everyone. Thank you for your patience. My name is Dr. Olumide Olasukomi Dada. I am a proud alumnus of this university, and it's easy to calculate how long we graduated. We graduated in 2000. So anything 2022, we are the lucky one, the millennium graduate. So yeah, 2030, we are coming to revenge. And by that time, it is JET that we'll be packing, JET, and then we are not going to be sponsoring the student. By God's grace, we are going to be sponsoring the university. So let's take the national anthem. We take the anthem, just the national anthem. And after that, we'll have the group photographs. In case I have forgotten anything, just pardon me. Sometimes too, it happens like that. But I've looked at every paper that I've been given. I think I have fulfilled that part. The national anthem of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. God bless you all. Class of 92, please let's quickly take the good pictures. Thank you, the ushers. Appreciate ushers. Thank you. Thank you, our dear chairman. Ashigon. Group photographs. Group photographs. Let's quickly take the group photographs and then we extend the place entries. Ibadan class, physiotherapy class of 92. Group photographs. Let's quickly do the group photographs. Thank you. Good photographs. Dr. Dewey. Please, we extend the pleasantries. Let's quickly take the good photograph outside by the step of the college building, the administrative building. That's where we take the photographs. Administrative building. Yes, the group photographs. The class, we're starting with the members of the I-table. We're starting with physiotherapy lecturers, the chairman, the alumni, and everybody.
Amazing. It's Be Mine's production.
Lady Gun, no.
I go, shit.
And I know the music ain't bad. You don't hear.
Because I'm getting money, hey. Oh, God has blessed, God has blessed. Man can cause, man can cause. I will do my best, I leave the rest for God. Why you want to bring me down? Not because I run the town. Why you want to bring me down? Bepokun, bepokun, I miss the way the crown. Now, nobody wawawu, walo kubi tamagba. Awati lo atu, jaye, wafe jati wagba.
I'm